when you're working on a book for so long, time starts to lose all meaning. It's like watching a plant grow. You're like, I don't even remember when I dropped the seed in the pot. What we're going to see on this visit is just a narrow slice, because it takes the better part of a month for the full process. You print all the pages, but then you have to gather those together into the sections, and there's a whole sewing process with all these spindles of thread. The older I get, the more humbled I am by all of the contributions that have been made by creative people going back, stretching back infinitely into the past. It's inspiring. It's inspiring. I mean, you can't be in a place like this without feeling like whatever the bar is, it's been raised. If we can inspire each other, and Andrew and I can do work and bring together artists and writers and designs and printed pages that are inspiring and beautiful, then it doesn't really matter. There's no past, there's no future. There's only the project that's laid out on the table in front of us today.
I mean, are you excited?
Oh, I'm like, I could barely sleep. I'm gonna play some Atari. Hi!
I'm Lucia, nice to meet you.
Hi, Lucia!
I will call you and we will go downstairs for press checks.
Amazing.
Soul Arts is destined for this gap right here.
So let's nod and look very serious. No. So exciting. Oh my God. You see almost a glimmer, a shadow of it on the plates that they put down in, and then somehow it just, those pages fly through there and it puts all the colors down. It just feeds my curiosity. The more I learn, the more I want to learn. And so I want to know how books are made, like down to the atomic layer. Like all of the ink, the different color ink that they're slathering in there might as well be like Willy Wonka's chocolate factory, like a river of, lemon drop, drizzle. I don't know. I don't even know what the right metaphor is.
I've not seen kind of a material like this before.
Every single little symbol here is a reference to something in those games.
Yeah, no, it's amazing seeing it in this format. You see the finer details, seeing, a really, really high quality book being printed by one of the best printers in the world. It's just a pinch me moment,
All of the little references to the games just trigger your curiosity and also your gratitude. Soul Arts doesn't exist without Miyazaki's genius. The things he's created have seeped into the, the creative groundwater that's fed this entire book.
A metallic can sometimes disappear, when you get the shine across it.
The spine of the book, this was originally a gold paper.
So that was the gloss, that's the matte. That's so much more arresting than the original paper that we had.
Of course it was gonna cost more, it was a nicer solution, but it was something that we could just immediately say yes to because of the support that we got for the book.
And like, fantastic definition.
This is something special, this. I mean, that's, you can imagine, like, £10,000 piece of jewelry coming in a box, coming in this, just like.
The goal is to make something that is just unnecessarily beautiful. Just for the sake of it existing in its most sublime potential.
You prefer a darker effect.
We'd like a warmer feel, as opposed to a more cyan, kind of more cool. Spending 2 days with the team at Conti, you leave
feeling like your project is in the most confident set of hands. It's hard to avoid birth analogies when you're working on a project and you have your brainchild, so to speak, but Conti is the midwife and they are the ones helping bring this project into the world and giving it physical form. You get a glimpse of it when you're in that place and you're looking at the pages and you're seeing all the different pieces and your imagination can't help but stitch them all together and create this picture of what the final project is going to look like. I love when you feel like a place is so inspiring that it forces you to use all of your senses and just because you want to take it all in. It's amazing, like these are originals from the 1600s, like original engravings. Can we go inside?
Yeah. Yeah.
That's beautiful. Is it okay if I'll be very careful with this. You know, who's gonna top the artists in the Uffizi Gallery? Say, all right, well, they've already existed. We don't have to duplicate that kind of creative contribution. Like, just do your bit.
It's too much to take in.
I know. Opening this book is just gonna be like tipping back the lid on a treasure chest full of a pile of treasure. And Florence, you know, going back to the birth of the printing industry here.
Tipografia Italo Conti. Italo was our grandfather. This Giorgio is another Giorgio.
Yes.
He died during the Second World.
I was seeing the old linotype and things like that, and it really took me back, you know, like my dad taking me to a printing press.
Do you have a son or...?
I have a son and a daughter. I love the industrial, just the dirt and there's all of this work that's happening, but then it creates this immaculate object.
They look like they were really excited and proud to be working on our project. Just really exciting and absolute pleasure to work with those guys and see them. You know, they're artisans and they're, they're the best.
To have the CEO actually looking after our project in a concierge sort of treatment, it's really amazing. Like all of the people who've ordered the book, that's what enables it to get that kind of care and attention, is because there are so many people invested in it. It's more than just a book. Like, for them, it's a family and it's their life. There's a real vitality to that. You know, there's blood and ink, and we're just marrying those two things together.